No.
I could go on.
I'm gonna come down there and kick your ass.
Hello, beta testers.
Hey, plumber boy, mustache man, your worst nightmare has arrived.
Pack up your stuff.
After what feels like years of waiting. Oh wait, it was years of waiting. Sony is finally ready for a showcase. And as an older fan who really misses the days when they just drive a katana into the heart of competition.
Steve Reyes, join me for a brief presentation.
This is Sony in 1995, killing the competition, announcing the PlayStation 1 $100 less than its competition. And if that's too far back for you to remember, here's Sony again in 2013 when they did the same thing with the PlayStation 4.
The PlayStation 4 will be available at $399.
A stronger console, $100 cheaper.
My heart.
You know what I mean? Cause they're Japanese.
I got it.
You think they'll get it? Should I leave this part in? So you know.
No, you gotta go extra console.
PlayStation.
My name is Kyle, and it's time for a definitive, official 10 most hyped games for the PlayStation Showcase. If you disagree, the comment section's right there. But trust me. These are the games, baby. Doesn't mean they're going to be there. You know, it's just what we wish that we could see. And based on that description, you already know what number one is. Well, you're not a real gamer. You know, fight me about it in the comment section. Number 10. Last of Us Factions. Now, I'm sure somebody's thinking this should be higher. Nah. Wait until you see the rest of the list, man, you know. Fresh off the heels of the popularity of The Last of Us TV show. Good job, you know what I mean? I guess it was doable, huh, Halo? Jesus Christ, do I have to talk about this one? Oh, yeah. Yeah, bitch. Yeah, you remember me? Is it good for you? Is it good for you? You remember me? There you go. You like that? You like getting stuck? You remember me, boy?
Number 9, right? I just go to number 9. There's an unannounced FPS project that Sony, you know, I'm sure they probably have multiple, but the one that they're willing to just kick out the door and have revealed, that's the one that we want to see. Mainly because Halo got me thinking about it. Battlefield, Halo, Call of Duty, people aren't feeling Destiny. Come on, man. We need a new shooter game because, you know, the ones that we have so far. And it's not that we're even expecting them to not be greedy. It would help if they just don't suck. Is that too much to ask? It's not a lot to ask. I mean, it's pretty reasonable. Pretty reasonable stuff. Number 8. Ghost of Tsushima. This wakizashi signed Echi no Kami Kanekuni from the Enkyo era, 1744 to 1748. Fucking sick. Oh, fucking sick. Sick. It's fucking sick. After a while, reproduction katana just weren't doing it for me anymore. So I wanted more Nihonto, like the wakizashi. Sick! Fucking sick! You see this?
A phenomenal game by phenomenal developers that of course people are interested in more from. I mean, in case anyone forgot, Sucker Punch followed up the release of Ghost of Tsushima with a free Legends update that had its shit together better than most games come out these days. You know what I'm saying? Marvel's Avengers, Gotham Knights, Saints Row. All of these games that were supposed to be, you know, multiplayer centric. Just fart. Reverberating fart. You know what I mean? But not Sucker Punch.
Even though I can't see my deer, but my sense of direction takes me here with little inspection. inside of your girl. Penetration, I'm about to rock that world. One stroke, two stroke, about 50. This pussy's pretty nifty. I'm about to blow it up. My man, he got the stuff. We in the...
So take your time. You know what I mean? That's how you secure a future. And you don't get rolled into other studios with your woke cringe, with your shit writing. You're gonna explain to us until we understand that your game's actually not that bad. Oh.
Number 7, Death Stranding 2. Legendary visionary Hideo Kojima strikes again like lightning with what will certainly be a follow-up to the last Death Stranding. Did you like delivering things before? Because this time, it's gonna be like the last time, but a different kind of number 6. Mortal Kombat 12.
But honestly, Ed Boon's like a pussy hypocrite, and you know, if he's so scared of women but thinks gore is fine, then I can talk about Street Fighter 6 and how I'm definitely buying that, man. Something about it, you know? You just want to support developers that are doing something that you agree with and you want to see more of, and I will vote with my wallet. Now, I'll probably buy this game. I'll probably buy Street Fighter 6 for another person because it's that good. You know what I mean? Number 6, Street Fighter 6. You know what I'm saying?
Number 5, Silent Hill 2 Remake. A lot of sequels.
Well, you know, what's wrong with that? You know, you give the people what they like and you give them more what they like. You don't feel the need to race or gender swap everything, and everything should be all right, man. You know what I mean? You know, sometimes people like what they like. What's the big deal? Ooh, you know? Ooh!
Number 4. Armored Core, whatever number sequel it is, Fires of Rubicon. Listen, people don't even remember what Armored Core is. All they need to know is it's a robot game, but specifically that it's made by From Software. You remember those guys who made that Elden Ring game? Those Eastern developers that made that game that people appreciated? Probably because they just couldn't find the time to put all the cringe writing in there that, you know, the Western devs are all about. Maybe they couldn't find the time to make all the women flat-chested and just ugly and you know, fuck, man. Damn. Oh, gee, they spilled the video game all up in their video game. They missed the memo. It should have been educational, not entertaining. Entertaining? What, are you trying to score fans around here? I am so sorry.
Number 3, Metal Gear Solid 2. Again. Re-release? Remake? Remaster? HD collection? I don't know. Whatever it is.
It's over. Metal Gear Solid came out in 2001. That's over 20 years ago. And over 2 decades ago, it was making predictions about the state of the world that we're in right now, like it was a Simpsons episode or something. In my opinion, there is no game more worthy of a remaster, a remake, as close to the original as you can keep it, than Metal Gear Solid. Number 2, of course, is Spider-Man 2. By the legendary Insomniac Games. We all wait with bated breath to see how you push this industry forward by choosing not to stagnate, but instead to innovate. Greed and incompetence has brought portions of this industry to an absolute stagnation point. As it pertains to quality, you can throw a rock and hit a dozen Superman 64s. I want to see the future. You know, Fortnite shows us that. Given the tools to people not just to edit a level or create a little mode, but to create entire games, that's the future. That's where gaming came from. People modding, people editing. What do you think number 1 is here? And the tragedy of number 1 is we should have heard about number 1 a long time ago, but because of all of the money that was to be made in GTA 5, GTA 6 took this long to show. But if there's one thing that I'm eager to see, it's the evolution.
an upgrade, not a downgrade. Like, we're going to give this girl A cups versus the jiggle physics we had in the last game. And the comedy of that is even Grand Theft Auto, a game that wants to sell, you know, cards to make money. And oh, can't you buy our outfits? But the NPCs have better physical proportions and assets than the playable girl characters. I can't wait to see that change. Because if the leaks were anything to go off of, that's delicious. That's what we see. Don't not be like TikTok and Instagram and Twitch and... Oh, man, come on, you know? Come on! So I'll see you. You know, E3's dead now, man. All you have is me. Like and subscribe.
He's going the distance and he shot you. You're nothing, nigga. Get a clue right in your face. Right in your face. Right in your face. What a disgrace. Reload my gun. Shoot you for fun. Who is better, nigga? I am the chosen one. Here they come from inside. And I need to reload to stay alive. Damn, the nigga bounced and that was funny. Turn around, my nose was runny. He caught me slipping, fucking dripping down my shirt. It's not my mission, special edition. Things are glitching. And welcome to the Kyle Show.